Thank you to Simthic, accessible via sim.gg for the weapon stats used in making this video. Link in the description. Hello, this is yet another entry into a series I've been calling Final Meta, an exploration into the infantry weapons in Battlefield 5 following its final content release. In this video, I will be covering the three bolt-action carbines. This includes the Commando Carbine, the Jungle Carbine, and the M28 Con Tromboncino. These are, generally speaking, the best long-range options available to the medic players. Even the longest-ranged SMGs don't really hold a candle to the bolt-action carbine's effectiveness over range, assuming you can land headshots. Getting into my recommendations, these are the only weapons in the meta class I can solidly suggest the combat medic combat role. Using these longer-ranged bolt-action weapons, you will generally speaking be farther away from your team's main frontal assault force, and revives, while still important, are less emphasized as a result. When it comes to the upgrades you get with the combat medic role, you will be more likely to have reason to use the longer-ranged melee, as if you find yourself suddenly in closer quarters, you will absolutely be reliant on your sidearm and melee weapon far more. The emergency sprint boost given when at critical health will more likely come into play as well than with the SMGs, as the damage you will receive will generally be more gradual, due to the lower long-range damage values from your opposition, meaning their time to kill will be slow enough that this should afford you the ability to more quickly find cover so you can safely heal up. As for sight suggestions, I generally advise a 2x scope for the M28, the iron sights for the Commando Carbine, and the 3x scope for the Jungle Carbine. As for the gadgets, this is an instance where things get a bit complicated. Starting with the Commando Carbine, seeing as you will be using a suppressed weapon, flanking becomes fairly important. So, the smoke grenade and smoke grenade launcher will still hold a lot of utility in obtaining those flanks. But since you will be generally away from your team as a result of that flanking tactic, using a health crate holds the utility of being a medic away from home, so to speak. Further, if you find yourself sniping with the Commando Carbine behind cover, you'll be stationary a decent amount. You can place the crate down before you initiate firing on your targets, and the passive area of effect healing will help buff your survivability a little. The M28 is unique in that it effectively turns the medic class into a jack of all trades, especially if you upgrade the grenade launcher. And you should exploit the medic's newfound anti-vehicle weapon by selecting other anti-tank gadgets. My primary suggestion is to select the Type 99 mines, medic crate, and smoke grenade launcher. The Type 99 mines will deal the most damage to vehicles if used in an active way in combination with the M28's upgraded grenades. Let me explain how to best use this setup. The process is that you will want to first switch to the M28's grenade launcher ahead of time. If necessary, fire the smoke launcher to cover your approach, so you can actually place the magnetic Type 99s on your targeted tank, at least semi-safely. After tossing both of the mines, put some space between you and the tank until the mines detonate. The moment that they do, fire your grenade launcher. Be wary of tanks that have the upgrade that prevents the mines from sticking, and try to wait for them to detonate if they drop to the ground, so they will still deal some damage if the tank continues being unaware of you. You generally won't be likely to survive long enough to reload the grenade launcher, so switch to your sidearm and find cover as soon as possible, and reload both of the M28's grenade launcher and the smoke grenade launcher once you are safe. If there is an ammo crate around, try and reach it and start the process all over again, keeping the grenade launcher ready if the tank spots you. Don't switch back to the standard firing mode of the M28 to engage infantry. Instead, simply switch to and rely upon your sidearm, so you don't waste time switching back and forth between the M28's firing modes, especially since switching to the grenade firing mode can take quite a long time. There is one other anti-vehicle gadget selection. It instead involves the demolition grenade and AP mines. While the AP mines and demolition grenades deal less damage than their beefier brethren found in the assault class and support class arsenals, if a large ammo box can be found, you can place a grand total of 4 mines in your immediate vicinity. First place the mines you have, then refresh your stock at the ammo box. You'll be able to place one more of each before they begin to despawn. You can either place them near each other to maximize damage to a single target, or if you have the time, spread them throughout and use them as detectors, with your grenade launcher at the ready while hidden behind cover. Of course, the medic crate largely serves the same purpose as with the commando carbine. Use it to cover for your more stationary sniping as a passive healing buff, or place it among your team's main force, since you will be generally farther away from them. That said, the M28 is the one bolt-action carbine where you can arguably justify using the bandages, as if you want to help assault or support classes take on the tanks, you might actually decide to stick closer to your squad mates, making the more active and mobile bandages an arguably better choice. You could also go all out and select the Type 99 and AP mines to maximize your damage potential against tanks, but they don't synergize particularly well, one being active in its use and the other being passive in its use, and you are better off focusing on one tactic or another. Finally, what is largely one of the most popular of the three bolt-action carbines, the Jungle Carbine is basically the closest you can get to a full bolt-action sniper rifle using the Medic class. As a result, the gadgets that work the best with it are the Incendiary Grenade, Medic Crate, and AP Mines. Use the Incendiary Grenade to create an immediate wall of fire between you and the possible close-range aggressors, allowing you to control your engagement range to suit the rifle better. Use AP Mines to defend your sides or rear of wherever your sniper perch is, alerting you to the presence of rushers. The Medic Crate, as usual, can act as a passive healing crate if you place it nearby before you begin sniping, improving overall survivability in a possible long-range duel. Sidearms are probably one of the more important pieces of kit to a bolt-action weapon of any kind, and need to largely strike a balance between ammo reliability, deploy speed, and time to kill, making it so that middle road pistols or alternative primaries tend to be most useful. For the Jungle Carbine sidearm, the Mark VI revolver is the best option, as it fills the gap of the Jungle Carbine's poor close-range abilities with a close-range powerhouse that is also decent as an alternative primary due to its okay ammo reliability. The drawback of a slow deploy time is made up somewhat by the slings and swivels upgrade I suggest for the Jungle Carbine. And if you placed AP mines or are quick-witted enough to throw an incendiary to cover for its slower deploy time, this drawback is further mitigated. For the Commando Carbine sidearm, I suggest the PPK Suppressed. You might as well stay stealthy by using a suppressed sidearm to go along with the Commando Carbine Suppressor. Out of the three options in that case, the PPK ends up doing a better job filling in the close range gap better than the well rod will, and it will kill faster than the M1911 in general. For the M28, I suggest the P38. The P38 is good in this case because it's very easy to use and manage, with a fast reload, low recoil, and clear irons, faster than average deploy time, and decent damage over middle range. It perfectly strikes a balance in stats and works well for a primary with both sniping and anti-tank utility, and being an all-in-one close-range weapon. Melee weapons, like sidearms, are similarly important for bolt actions, as they further assist in filling the gap in close-range performance. For the Jungle Carbine and M28, I suggest the hand tools because of the damage profile. A hand tool provides enough damage with a single hit to finish off your opponent if you've landed a body shot in close quarters. This is better than the other two options. A knife or blunt weapon would require an additional hit. For the Commando Carbine, the improved assassination radius of the knife is a perfect fit for the weapon. Don't get me wrong, the hand tools can also be an okay choice, as they'll enable you to finish off a target in melee range following a single landed hit with the Commando Carbine, just like the other two rifles. But seeing as the weapon is obviously best for stealth, an assassination focus fits the role of the gun better. For the upgrade tree of the Commando Carbine, I suggest left, right, left, resulting in slings and swivels, high-velocity bullets, machined bolt, and enhanced grips. This gives the commando the most flexible and reactive setup, allowing for potential one-hit headshots even with hip fire, mainly due to the slings and swivels, machined bolts, and enhanced grips upgrades. It also permits a faster time to kill with the machined bolt and high velocity upgrade at longer ranges if it is really needed. Seeing as you don't need to be really concerned with scope glare or slow aim down sight speed with my iron sight suggestion, quick aim is less potent and is less important since you would be flanking, making reactive sniper dueling less common, assuming proper tactical use of the gun. As typical, I find custom stock particularly useless without lightened stock, and a especially poor choice on a bolt action, seeing as you should try and stand still whenever you fire for perfect accuracy. Quick reload and extended magazine are statistically weak and not super helpful, as the commando carbine already has the best ammo reliability of the three bolt action carbines. For the jungle carbines tree, I suggest right, left, right, resulting in quick aim, slings and swivels, machined bolt, and enhanced grips. Because I advise the 3x scope, managing your scope glint is an important thing to keep in mind. You don't want to be scoped in all of the time. This makes quick aim fairly important, because while you don't need to scope out to cycle your bolt, you still don't want to be aimed on your sight all of the time, as you will quickly give away your position. The other upgrades largely just round out the package and provide a more mobile build, something you'll want, since the weapon still can't quite compete at the very long ranges that the full-size bolt actions can compete at. You'll need to move to a specific ideal range for your engagements a tad more than other bolt actions will, which may result in some close quarters combat coming up more often. That said, if you are particularly confident that you can reasonably dodge lots of incoming fire and don't mind announcing yourself with scope glint, or you plan on using the 2x scope, which doesn't have glint, I suggest left, right, right instead. With this alternative build, you will attract a lot of attention with the 3x scope, or you will be handicapped with a weaker zoom. But you'll be able to stay scoped in and fire round after round without having to unscope, using the lightened stock to dodge enemy fire and landing headshots a bit more easily with the notably improved bullet velocity. This can be a potent tactic. For the M28, I suggest right, left, right. This results in slings and swivels, quick reload, enhanced grips, and improved grenades. The last upgrade is the star of the show, resulting in a grenade launcher that deals improved damage against vehicles, though this is at the cost of the grenade launcher's effectiveness against infantry. The other grenades largely provide you with a rifle built around capitalizing on this unique feature. Slings and swivels will allow you to raise the grenade launcher faster if you sprint towards a tank, or switch to your sidearm quickly for some quick anti-infantry work, which you'll need to do more frequently with the advised loadout. And the quick reload affects both the M28 and its grenade launcher, saving you about a half a second of time reloading the grenade launcher, which effectively speeds up its rate of fire, as well as alleviating the M28's otherwise mediocre ammo reliability. Enhanced grips is mostly icing on the cake. It allows the bolt action to function reasonably well in close quarters, which may come up more often if you stick to your teammates more, which can result in less predictable or controllable engagement ranges. You can run the M28 in a more straightforward fashion, with left, right, left. This will turn it into a more general mid to long range anti-infantry weapon, where you can use the grenade launcher to clear out rooms of infantry in smaller maps, like Al Marsh Encampment or Operation Underground. In case you do so, I change my suggested gadgets to frag grenades, bandages, and EP mines, and suggest the iron sights. The general advised tactics of the three bolt action carbines vary pretty significantly. The commando carbine is a very potent flanker's tool. Its high damage per shot for a suppressed weapon allows you to minimize your overall audio-visual footprint, and within 25 meters, you can put a target down in a single headshot, and a two-hit kill regardless of hit location out to 50 meters. Its slower bullet velocity does restrict its longer-ranged use to a certain degree, but its faster bolt action performance that cycles even when scoped in, suppressed nature, and perfect pinpoint accuracy while standing still can allow you to quickly place a handful of deadly hits at range where your target will have no effective means of finding cover reliably, as they won't know where the fire is coming from. Use the smoke grenades to assist in getting those flanks. Place yourself just outside capture points and clear the enemy out for your team from their rear. And once a larger portion of your team arrives or your squad spawns on you, hop onto the point with them. Just remember to stand still when you fire for longer ranges. The Jungle Carbine is essentially a pocket sniper rifle. It's more dedicated to the role of reaching out to your enemy. It is capable of getting a one-hit kill up to 75 meters if you land headshots. And with its relatively sizable magazine of 10 rounds and rapid bolt action paired with the ability to cycle even while scoped in, permits a fairly aggressive and spammy sniping technique for those outside the 75 meter range, allowing multiple hits in relatively rapid succession. Though you should be wary, as its reloads are very slow, resulting in poor ammo reliability compared to the other two bolt action carbines. The damage profile permits a 2-hit kill regardless of headshots, all the way out to 100 meters, and a 2-hit kill out to any range, as long as one of the hits is a headshot. So pick a sniper perch, place down a health crate nearby behind some cover, place some AP mines near any common entrances, and start sniping away. Finally, the M28 is one of the more interesting weapons available to the meta class, as if it's combined with various other anti-vehicle equipment, as previously stated, it can allow the meta class to be a mix of different classes, with its ability to revive and heal, snipe people from longer ranges, and act as an anti-tank class if built up properly. But the limitations are notable in the weapon's actual ballistics and damage profile. It's only capable of getting a one-hit headshot kill out to 50 meters, and a two-shot kill regardless of where you land a hit up to 75 meters. And like the Jungle Carbine, a two-hit kill beyond that as long as one of your hits is a headshot. But its bullet drag is somewhat worse compared to the Jungle Carbine, making its performance at longer ranges feel more inconsistent. This means you really should stick to middling ranges of 40 to 50 meters. The weapon is capable of helping out in basically all situations, but not really being able to be totally independent. In conclusion, the takeaway from the medic's small collection of bolt actions is that they are what you pick out when you want to engage at long ranges. However, each provides a potent and unique tactical opportunity. The Commando Carbine is for flanking, the M28 is when you want to be able to also engage with tanks, and the Jungle Carbine is when you just want to focus on long-range kills and don't need any other bells and whistles. Thank you for watching my video to the end. Please like, comment, subscribe, and click the bell for notifications.